Hello, I'm Calm Cal. Welcome to the channel. In this video, we're going to look at changing an SSD drive. This is my SD drive, an 860 Evo, which is my boot up drive. And the drive space on there, there's not very much left, to be honest. And I've actually purchased a 1TB NVMe drive. So I want to install all of my programs that I use daily onto this new NVMe drive. So what I'm going to do is just clone the drive, my current C drive, and then put all the information onto this new drive. A lot of these NVMe drives come with free software to do this. I've recently had two NVMe drives. One I've installed in my son's computer as an upgrade, and one for me as well. They both come with free software. Here is a previous video just comparing these two drives together. So with this Crucial P1, you can actually go to the Crucial site, which is shown here. And then if we go to support, we can see here that we can actually select some software called Acronis and use it for cloning the drive. So we just click on here and then select the download button. Then you can see it's downloading to the downloads folder. You can also click this as well just to see the manual for this software. And there's all different things in here. Acronis is available on its own as software and is quite powerful. A lot of people recommend it. Doesn't just clone, does other things as well, like backing up and all sorts. So you can see here it comes free with this Crucial SSD, and here's the basics to installing Acronis, which is fairly simple. So once that's downloaded, click into your downloads folder. There it is, Acronis. What we're just going to do is just click on here to run it. Select OK on here, and then it'll start unpacking. And there we are. Select this button here to install. Just let it install. Say it is free for Crucial. But if you've got other SSDs like a Samsung one, you get free software with this as well to do a similar thing with cloning your drive. So I'm just going to select start application here. You have to accept the agreement, so put a little tick in there and then select OK again. And there we've got the about page, so just click on there. And then we go to the tools page and we select clone disk. So all these different features as well that it's got. Obviously it's a lot of this is locked out to us. So just gonna select clone disk. I suggest use automatic, this way it will clone the whole of the drive. You can select manual if you wish, but then you'll have to select the files individually for yourself. So just select automatic if you want to clone the whole of the drive. Then click next. So here we have to tell it which drive we want to select to copy. Samsung one is already highlighted here, so I'm just going to select next. It's just reading that drive now. In a second it'll give us the option to select which drive we want to copy to. So here it's just listed as disk 1, 2, 3 and 4, but we know that we've got an NVMe drive. And it's listed here as a Crucial T1000P. So this is the one that we want. So just highlight this one and then select next. It's just a warning here, just advising you that everything's going to be wiped off there. So select OK and now it does its magic. We'll start reading the Samsung one and then start working out what different partitions it needs to copy across to the Crucial one. So this is going to be the before and after picture, and then we just select proceed. So as you can prepare everything, just check all the files that's on the supplier SSD to the clone SSD. We'll give you a brief idea of how long it's going to take. Mine's got quite a bit of information on there, and mine took half an hour, but it is making an exact copy of the SSD. So it's starting off with 21 minutes. So we're just going to use the magic of editing and go through to the end stages. So we've not got long left now. Right, the disk was successfully cloned. So you need to turn off your computer, remove the source drive, install the clone drive in place of the source drive. Just select OK on here. So I'm just going to shut the computer down, turn off the power, let the power drain from what's already in there. So I'm just going to disconnect the source drive. The NVMe drive is already installed. If you're unsure how to install one of these, check out this video here. And as I turn my computer on, I just want to double check that it's going to be booting to the correct drive. So what I'm doing now is just going to the boot menu within the BIOS and just making sure that the boot option for number one is this new drive that I've just installed, which is the CT100P1, and that is down as boot manager boot option number one. I'm going to select on here is exit, and then it'll be save changes and reset. That's this. Okay. It's just going to boot up from the NVMe drive. And there we are, it's an exact replica of the original source drive, and it's named itself as the source drive, which is 860 Evo, but obviously this is an NVMe drive now, so we just need to rename it. So you can see how much space is on this new drive now, so I'm just going to rename it as a Crucial P1 NVMe 1TB drive, and then when you select OK, it says that you need permission, so just click continue and then OK, and here you can now see it, Crucial P1 NVMe C drive, the main drive. Right click on here, properties, so I've now got 574GB free. Still waiting for packages to arrive from China. I hope you enjoyed this video. My name is Cal, have a good morning, afternoon or good evening, farewell till next time, and I'll see you later. Thanks for watching.